गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर कंप्यूटर क्लासरूम। एज वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट कंप्यूटर वायरस एंड सिक्योरिटी रिस्क इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लास, वी हैड ऑल्सो सीन व्हाट आर द टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड इन दिस चैप्टर, लाइक कंप्यूटर सिक्योरिटी रिस्क, वायरसेस, डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ वायरसेस, how our computer gets infected through virus. So these all topics we had discussed, and now today we are going to deal with virus protection, email attachments which consist of viruses. When we click on that attachment or the link which has been provided to the other person by the hackers, and their computer gets affected with the virus. So let's revise the previous topics and then we will start with the next topic. So coming to the textbook, Computer Virus and Security Risk. This is the heading of the chapter. Okay, so computer risk is a term which includes what? Computer risk is a term known for any event or action that could be harmful for a computer, hardware, software, data, information and processing capability. Okay, so any action which is harmful for your computer related to hardware, software, data or information or processing is termed as computer security risk. Someone breaches to the computer security accidental while others are planned. Some people are there who plan to steal your data and information. So in this also there are two categories divided. One is a computer crime and other is a cyber crime. So any illegal act involving a computer data is referred to as computer crime. And any illegal act involving internet and online is referred to as cyber crime. Means you are working in your home and suddenly your friend came to your house and he sits with you and see all your data and he asked for a glass of water, and when you went to take a glass of water, he suddenly puts his pen drive insert in your CPU and copy all the data and information from your computer till you come back. What happens? This is computer crime. He is stealing data from the computer. But in cyber crime, the person is using internet and online facility to take your data, to access your computer. He is using the technology of online network. He is not sitting with you or in front of your computer. He is stealing your data and destroying your computer from some other source. Sitting somewhere else with the help of internet and online, he is just breaches your computer and stealing your data. And even you don't know. So this is a cyber crime. The very little difference between computer and cyber crime. Computer crime involves what? Computer datas. And cybercrime involves internet online. Okay? Now, virus. Virus stands for Vital Information Resources Under Siege. This question can be asked in your examination also. What is virus, or virus stands for? So what are virus? So virus is a program which are created deliberately to damage critical information and data. Okay? To damage critical data and information. Okay, it is a program which is created to damage the information and data inside your computer. So this virus can badly affect or infect your computer without your knowledge, and also alter the working of your computer. Alter means change. Your computer starts getting slower day by day, and even you don't know. So these means that these are affected by virus. Your computer has been affected by a virus. Next, it gets triggered and becomes active. One such notorious virus is called Friday 13 virus, which is also known as Jerusalem virus. Why? Because this is discovered in where? University of Jerusalem in 1987. Okay. Next, how does a computer get infected by virus? The increased use of internet and email has accelerated the speed of computer virus. With these technologies, computer users can easily share files and any related viruses. Now there is no restriction or bondation. They easily can share their files and related virus to your computer, because our most of the activities are related to the internet and email. These have given the speed to the computer viruses. Next, virus get activated on your computer in four basic ways. What are the four basic ways? The first one is opening an infected file. If you are opening any infected file, your computer gets infected. Second, running an infected program. Third, booting the program with an infected CD or pen drive. So that's why we use what? Antivirus. First they scan the pen drive or CD which you are inserting, then it opens it. Downloading an infected file from the internet. If you are downloading any infected file which consists of viruses, then your computer gets infected. Virus in computer are not generated accidentally, but are programmed intentionally by a programmer who is known as what? Virus author. Okay, remember this word, virus author. It is a programmer who planned a program intentionally and sent to your computers. Now, types of viruses. So we had already discussed worm, harmless virus which replicates itself, means make a copy of itself. Trojan horse, friendly program, as a game and application you are downloading. So it is very dangerous, can destroy your data on your system. File infector, it adds viruses code to the regular programming code with the program files. So when we run the infected program, our computer gets infected. Boot sector virus. This attaches itself to the boot sector of the disk. And the sector is the part of the disk where startup instruction and the file allocation tables are kept. So this sector is read and loaded into the memory every time the disk is booted. So every time what happens? Virus activated more fastly. So your computer becomes useless one day. Okay. Now, next one is rootkit, spyware and adware. Okay, rootkit, what happens? Hides in a computer and allows someone for a remote location to take full control of the computer. Means you are having your computer in front of yourself, but you cannot access it. Some other people are accessing it from some other place and even you don't know. So once the rootkit is installed, the rootkit author can execute programs, change settings, execute programs, change settings, monitor activities, and access files from a remote computer. Okay? Spyware, the name itself tells, a program placed on a computer or mobile device without the user's knowledge, they secretly collects the information, means stealing information about the user, and then communicate the same information to some outside source while the user is online. When you are online doing any work, even you don't know, the spyware virus start collecting the information and send to the other persons. Adware, program that displays online advertisements in a banner or pop-up window. Window pages and email messages or the internet services. Clear? I hope you are all getting. Now, email virus, electronic mail, vital information resource under C is full form of virus. What happens? Email viruses are spread by the files attached to the email messages. Remember this. File attached to the email messages. As email attachments have become more common, the number of email virus has also increased. You cannot get an email virus from a message that contains only text. So this is also very important. Remember this. If there is no attachment, then a virus cannot enter in your computer through a text message only. Okay. So how email spreads? How email virus spread? Let's see. How email virus spread? When you open an email attachment that contains a virus, you are getting an email from some third party, or you have just seen in your inbox and you just opened it. There is an attachment, you just click on that. The virus spreads to your computer. If you forward the attachment to other people, so their computer will also be affected when they open the attachment. Means once a virus has been entered in your computer, that doesn't mean it just reaches to your computer only. When you are sending that file to others, then it is going with that file to others' computer also. Like you have seen file infector, it adds himself with the file, and then wherever you are sending this file, it goes with the file. Okay? Many emails, viruses can also access your email address book and automatically send themselves to the email address stored here. Yeah, this also can possible that many email viruses can also access your email address book, means you are having the email addresses of your friends, relatives, or the other members who are sending you mail. Automatically, this virus will send the mail to them. Means the address which is stored in your account, it will automatically send them the mail, and they will just click on the attachment. They think that you have sent it, and the what happens? The virus affect their computer also. Now, effect of virus on computer. What effects does virus create on our computer? It can damage or rename the important files. Whatever files you are having, it just rename them, change their name, or damage the files. It can damage or destroy the operating system also. Okay, so not only damaging the file or renaming the important files, it can also damage or destroy the operating system, the OS. Means Windows, DOS, Linux, whatever operating system you are using. it can decrease the speed of the computer. Your computer start getting slower day by day. It does not give you the performance as earlier it was providing. It can reduce the memory of the hard disk space. Why this happens? Because the viruses start making a copy of the files that will store the free space. So your memory or hard disk space get reduced. Okay. Now, next topic is virus prevention. How you can prevent your system with the viruses? How you can protect your system through viruses? So some simple steps can protect your computer from viruses. First, backing up important files frequently. If you have opened the backup, important files are stored somewhere where you have made your backup. There you are just backing up your important files time to time, day to day. All files that come from an unknown source should be checked with an antivirus program. Antivirus software installed in your system, it will check the files which are coming from unknown source. Then they should be used only when they are found to be totally virus free. If they are totally virus free, then you can install them, keep them. Sometimes a pop-up message comes at the bottom: this file can harm your computer, keep or discard. Okay, this file can harm your computer, keep or discard. So it's better to check that file. And again, if your antivirus is popping up a message that this file can harm your computer, so it's better not to use it, block it. Every computer should be equipped with some antivirus program. Means every computer must have an antivirus software. Many operating systems come with such programs. Nowadays, operating systems are having inbuilt antivirus application software. Okay. If not, they can be purchased from the market to keep the virus away. Okay. As an antivirus software is a utility software, so you can purchase from the market also to keep the virus away. So next, what is antivirus software? Okay, an antivirus program detects the changes that the virus causes in the computer. It will change that the virus cause in the computer. It will detect it, whatever the changes has been done in your computer. You should install an antivirus program to safeguard your computer from virus attacks and update it regularly. An antivirus program protects computer against virus, identifying or removing any computer virus found in the memory, storage, media, incoming files. So you can see, protect a computer against virus, identify also and remove if any computer virus found in the memory or storage media. So most antivirus programs automatically check for virus when they are first installed. If you're installing some softwares, some programs, some games to your computer, then it will first check it automatically and then it will give permission to install that. Antivirus program use virus signatures as one of their techniques for detecting virus. A virus signature is also called virus definition. Okay, you can say virus definition. Virus signatures are also called virus definitions. Is a known specific pattern for virus code. There is a specific pattern for the virus, specific pattern for virus code. It is necessary to update